Printed circuit boards often need a wire harness or cable assembly for connection to power input or other parts of the electronic system. One of the things a designer needs to think about with cable assemblies is the need for strain relief. How will you make sure that pulling on a cable during normal use will not damage the connection to the printed circuit board? There are several techniques we can use. For single wires and simple wire harnesses, it's common to crimp a connector onto the wire. This is typical for wire harnesses that are internal to the final system. In addition to having a contact that clamps onto the conducting wire, the crimp can have a flange that clamps onto the insulation. This provides strain relief to protect the connection during system installation and use. For more complex cable assemblies, we have strain relief backshells, commercial off-the-shelf parts that slide onto the cables and tighten onto the connector. They're great for low-volume production, but can cost from $1 each to $50 each for military-grade parts. So for higher volumes, over-molded strain relief is usually more economical. The cable assembly is placed into a mold, and then resin is injected into the mold to encase the cable and connector. This provides a strong and water-resistant strain relief. An upfront investment is needed to design and build the mold. With this low-temperature, low-pressure injection molding press, we can use an aluminum mold with an initial cost of about $10,000 to design and build. It is good for about 100,000 shots and then can be replaced for a little over $3,000. Overmolded strain relief can be completely customized with respect to size, shape, and material used. It can also provide superior performance compared to other strain relief techniques. Contact us to learn more about strain relief and other factors in the design and production of wire harnesses and cable assemblies for electronic products.